getting out of here and going back down from the peak area of this mountain is going to be harder than I thought. These are thistle bush brush. It's prickly amongst the wildflowers. It's very beautiful here. You can see I'm on a hillside of wildflowers, man. And we're in the end of July, and we have snow on most of these mountains with flowers growing. I did find a couple tracks, whether they are Bigfoot tracks or too worn and old to say. There was kind of a toe impression. The snow's been melting up here. They just opened the area, so, you know, it's like something may have came through this area. It turns out that that's not a cave. It's a shadow. Almost fell down the mountain. It's a shadow of a rock protruding out of the side of the camp on the peak. You can see it. But this is what we do, man. It's about, like I said, discovery. And you don't know what it is unless you're willing to climb and check it out and take a few risks. And this was worthwhile. The scenery's pretty. And I guess, what's the point of this video? What's it relate to paranormal investigating and all that? Well, you understand that for me, I worked hard to climb this. You know, this is like these are areas that man might walk through every, you know, 20 years, 100 years, 150 years. Nobody goes up the side of a mountain. The Sasquatch, I don't know, some of these peaks are 10, 12,000 feet, you know. There's caves up in these hills, there's dwellings, and Yosemite got the Mammoth Caves. Or now Cave City out there, and how about, yeah, Cave City has an extension of caves, or just a lot of caverns, a lot of mysteries. This isn't one, but the tracks that we captured and the strange slide mark, those are kind of things taken into consideration, you know. When a Sasquatch is first born, I'm sure it's only a few feet tall, so of course its heel might slide if they're running across the snow. I mean, animals slide too, so, and keep an open mind. I love doing what I do, but it's time to head home. It's brought to you by the Paranormal Ghost Society, your founder, author, producer, and talk show host of Angel of the Night Radio, Lord Rick. It's time to head home. Let's hope I don't slip and fall. As you can see, my feet, you could tell there's been something that walked up the side. These aren't my tracks. They came from a little bit different area, but you could see something, you know, made some holes. So deer walk up the side, you know, it's much more secluded. There's no people up here. It's amazing. It's going to get a lot steeper, so I'm going to have to stop the video. I might just go sledding and end up in this little glacier, tiny mini glacier. No, it's just snow building up, but it'll melt in August, and by then September will roll around and they'll start getting snowfall out here, and this area will be off limits to human activity. Thus, Bigfoot will continue to thrive and survive as long as we preserve the forest. Be responsible and cherish the land, because we always want to see this last forever so that you can enjoy it the same way I did. And this is God's country. If, you know, if you were to put it in words, it's like let's put it this way. This is a lost land. Lost land. I just want to thank everybody for your support. Tune in.